Good morning, students. So you are most welcome in class first, and I am Miss Samiksha, and I am your EVS teacher. Okay, so now we are going to start with our first chapter, and the name of the first chapter is Knowing About Me, means how much we do know about ourselves. Okay. So, in this chapter, there are some basic questions which are regarding your introduction. Like, if someone wants to know about you, then he or she will ask these questions to you and you have to answer them. So, I also want to know how much do you know about yourself. So, I am going to ask you these questions. And I will also explain these questions for you. Okay. So, here is the first question. If someone new coming to your house or meeting you first time, then what will his or her first question to you? It will be, what is your name? So, you are the class first students and you all can tell your name, right? So the student who is sitting here first line, your name is Akshat, right? So you have to write here your name. Whatever your name is, you have to write your name. Now, moving on the second question, what is your family name? What do you mean by family name? Family name is also called as surname, right? Like here is sitting Suhani, and Suhani's full name is Suhani Gupta. So Gupta is her family name and it is also called surname. Okay, so generally when people ask you what is your name, you tell your both names, your first name and your family name. Now, moving on the next question. How many people are there in your family? So, do you know how many people are living in your family? So, the number can vary here. Like in some families, some are big families, some students are living in small families, some are living in big families. Now, what do you mean by small families? Small families are those families in which parents and their children only they live, right? Parents and their children. Now, moving on, big families. Big families are those families in which parents are living with their children and a part of them, grandparents and other relatives like uncle, aunt, cousin can also be living with them. So these kinds of families are called big families. Got it? So how many people are there in your family? You have to write the members, the number of the members living in your family, like your parents, you and your sibling, your sister or brother. How many total members are there? In this way, you have to answer this question that there are four members in my family. Now, moving on the next question, how old are you? If someone is asking this question to you, it means he or she wants to know about your age. How old are you? Then you have to tell what is your age? How old are you? Are you 4 years old, 5 years old, 6 years old? Okay. Now, moving on the next question. Do you have brothers and sisters? Do you have brothers and sisters in your homes? If you have one brother or two brother, you have to say, yes, I have one brother and his name is this and that. Or there may be a sister also. So you have to tell, yes, I have one sister or two sisters. In this way, you have to introduce about your brothers and sisters, right? Now, moving on the next question. What would you like to be when you grow up? This is the most important and interesting question. Generally, your parents, your grandparents come and ask you, what would you like to be when you will grow up? So the question can, the answer can, the answer should be according to your interest, according to be your, with whom you are inspired by, right? If you are inspired by a doctor, that a doctor, you can see the doctor services the society, in which way he served the society. If you are inspired by the doctor, then you can say, I want to be a doctor. But for becoming a doctor, you have to do a lot of hard work, okay? And if you are inspired by a teacher, then you can say, I want to be a teacher, so that when you will be grown up, you can also teach small kids, right? So if you are inspired by your teacher, you can say, I want to be a teacher. And if you are inspired by a pilot, do you know what is the job of the pilot? Yes, flying the airplanes in the sky. And it is very interesting, it is very courageous job, right? So if you are inspired by a pilot, then you can say, I also want to be a pilot when I will be grown up. So according to your interest, you can write your answers here. Okay, now moving on the next topic of the chapter, we are going to the okay, students, so our next topic is very interesting, and it is about our friend and best friend. We make friends in school, we also make best friends. Do you have friends in the school? Right. All the students in your class, you are friends to each other. Why? Because you help each other, you share your things with each other, you sit together in the class, you eat together, you go to the playground for playing the games, and you have also one best friend. Best friend is that person with which you like to spend your time the most. So here are some questions regarding to your best friends. How much do you know about your best friend? So I am also going to check, how much do you know about your best friend and who is your best friend? The first question is, what is your best friend's name? So you have to write here your best friend's name. Like Suhani is sitting here. Suhani, tell me, who is your best friend? Surbhi. Surbhi Tiwari is your best friend, right? So you have to write here, Surbhi is my best friend. The name of my best friend is Surbhi. In this way, you have to write here, the name of my best friend is Surbhi. Now, the second question about your best friend is, what is his or her family name? Again, family name, which means surname. You have to write your best friend's surname here. Like, what is the surname of Surbhi? Her surname is Tiwari. So you have to write here, Suhani. For Suhani, I am telling this, my friend's surname is Tiwari. Okay. Now moving on the next question. When is his or her birthday? You should know about your friend's special day and which is his or her birthday. So you can wish him or her, you can say happy birthday, you can give him or her the best gift you want to give him or her. So you should know your best friend's birthday, right? How many of you in the class do you know about your best friend's birthday? Very nice. The whole class know about the his or her best friend's birthday. It is very good. Now, write one nice thing that you have done for your best friend. What things you like to do for your best friend? There are many things you can do for your best friend. You can help him or her in completing their work. You can help like sharing different kinds of things. You can play with them. You can spend your time with them. In this way, you can do many things for your best friend. So, what things you have done? Okay, let me ask. Let me ask Devraj. Devraj, what you have done the best thing for your best friend? You have given pencil him one day when he forgot to bring his pencil box. Very right. Very good. Yes. So there are lot of little things in which you can help your friends. You can make them happy. So you should care about your friends and your best friends. Okay, students. Okay, so this is enough for today. Now, once we will revise the whole we have done, we are going to revise it once again.